In today's date, most talked environmental concern is global warming and climate change. Hello and welcome back to my channel. Let's talk about how global warming happens and climate change occurs. We need to know first that Earth is surrounded with atmosphere, and this atmosphere is not uniform. There are atmospheric layers. These layers are known as troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere. The climate that we experience is in troposphere. All the greenhouse gases are present in troposphere. You must have heard about greenhouse. Greenhouse is constructed in plant nursery for growing plant sapling. Greenhouse creates necessary warmth required for plant growth. This idea came from nature. Earth is covered with greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide, chlorofluorocarbons, methane, water vapor, and nitrous oxide. When solar radiations are incident on Earth's surface, some radiations are absorbed, some radiations are trapped inside, and some radiations are reflected back in the atmosphere. This keeps Earth warm. This phenomena is essential for survival of life on Earth. In case of global warming, due to increase in greenhouse gases, layer of greenhouse gases gets thicker. In this case, when solar radiations are incident on Earth's surface, most of the radiations are trapped inside and very few radiations go outside or reflected back. This causes warming on Earth's surface, which is called as global warming. This increase in greenhouse gases is due to pollution. Let's see how greenhouse gases are increased in the atmosphere. Carbon dioxide is responsible for over half the human contribution to greenhouse emission. Carbon is emitted in atmosphere by burning of fossil fuels, industrial emissions, vehicular emissions, deforestation, respiration. Methane is released in the atmosphere by mixing of wet and dry waste, livestock raising, and burning of vegetation. During last few years, nitrous oxide has increased in atmosphere to a considerable extent. This happened because of increase in the use of nitrogen fertilizers. N2O is also released by combustion of wood and fossil fuels. Once nitrous oxide is produced, it can stay in the atmosphere for about 120 years. Chlorofluorocarbons are ozone depleting substances which are used as a cooling agent in refrigerator and air conditioners. It is also used in aerosol cans. Due to Montreal Protocol efforts were taken to reduce the use of chlorofluorocarbon and completely phase it out till 2030. Water vapors are formed due to warming of Earth's surface. Earth's surface warms because of presence of greenhouse gases. Water vapors also absorb solar radiation and warms Earth. We know that there is an ozone layer present in the stratosphere which protects us from UV radiations, but ozone present in the troposphere is a major greenhouse gas. It comes in troposphere by influx of stratosphere. Also, it is formed by the photochemical reaction of oxides of nitrogen, carbon monoxides, and volatile organic components. Global warming is affecting environment in various ways. There is an increase in global temperature, which is affecting health of all the animals. The planet's average surface temperature has risen about 2 degrees Fahrenheit during 2016 was the warmest year on record. Because of this warming, polar ice caps are melting, which causes frequent flooding conditions and sea level rise. As the climate is changing, forest fires, droughts are seen frequently. This affects agricultural productivity. Climate change also affects the economy of the country, which causes people to migrate, giving rise to various social issues. It also poses a threat to biodiversity as survival of species is at stake. Thank you so much for watching the video. Stay tuned for more such videos.